Ahoy, shipmates. Amy from Cruise Craze Fam. Welcome back to part two of our New Year's cruise. So we did a back-to-back cruise back in 2022 and 2023. As you would have seen on the New Year's cruise vlog, that it's not really like the rest of our cruises because we had no intention of vlogging back then. So this is more a series of photos and videos from our cruise just to vlog and remember the beautiful memory, since this was such a big cruise for us, for our family. So at the end of the last vlog, you noticed that we got off the ship back in Sydney and we did the Sydney Harbour Bridge climb. So this was such a great experience. This is a bucket list item. So if you are ever coming to Sydney, whether you live here in Australia or whether you're coming from another country, it is a great thing you can do. It gives you incredible views, not only of Sydney, but we got great views of the ship as well. So it's a good way to kind of just look out over the harbour and get some photos. They do not let you take photos yourself. You have to lock up your phone and stuff, but they will take photos for you to purchase at the end. So we head back to the ship after this. So we said goodbye to my parents. They went back home to Melbourne. And we got back on the ship. When we got back on the ship, we were greeted with this bottle of champagne and this bowl of fruit just to say thank you for being back-to-back passengers. That's all I had from embarkation day, but the next day was our sea day, and this is just Alira with her tail animals again, and we went into the atrium and played kind of like a game of Jenga run by the Fun Squad. So Alira had absolutely no idea what she was doing, but she had so much fun. And Ma, who was running the activity, she was great with Alira too and just helping her play with it. And then it was time for the Dr. Seuss story time. So, because this was post-COVID, there was no parade through the ship. It was just the story time show. And this night was also another formal night. So the next day was our port day. We were supposed to go to Tangalooma, Moreton Island, but instead we ended up going to the Brisbane International Cruise Terminal because of weather. So Ty and I were the only ones who got off, and we just went and did some shopping at DFO. We didn't really want to do too much exploring, so we just had an easy day, and Peter and Alira stayed on the ship. When we got back, of course, the kids went and did their favorite thing to do on their ship. So we went to the Splashy Cove so the kids could have a run around and a bit of a play. Now it was time for us to get ready for white night. So you'll see us getting all dressed up here for dinner, all in our white gear. Then it was time for the white night. So this party was pretty quiet. They didn't use the silent headphones since there was not enough of them on the last cruise, so they decided to scrap it for this one. So one thing that did happen on this cruise, Peter and the kids, they were chilling in the cabin. I decided to go for a walk, and as I exited the cabin, I came across a little girl all on her own, and she looked to me to be about 4, which is Alira's age now. And I tried to get her to communicate with me. So I just kind of asked, "Hi, are you okay? Where's your mom?" And I wasn't getting any reaction. And I picked up pretty quickly that I think this girl might be non-verbal autistic. So I decided to follow her. So we were kind of at the aft elevators on deck 7, and she started walking around the corridors. So I just followed her. And kept asking her questions, kept getting no response. But then eventually she just turned and gave me a cuddle. I could feel when I held her that she had a nappy on. And so that kind of solidified to me she's definitely nonverbal autistic. So I took her down to guest services. I saw a security guard there and he guided me to guest services, which was right there. So they took me inside of the guest services office. So I sat there with the girl, and she had already connected to me. So I didn't want to leave her with the crew members until she was with her mum. I don't, with a child with special needs, once they've got that connection, me as a mum, I'd just rather sit and wait with her until I know she's safe with her mum. And I know she would have been fine with the staff, but that was just my choice. We were having fun together. We were playing little games between each other. So I stayed with her. It took a while for them to work out who she was because they were thinking she was 6. And I'm going, "No, she's not 6. She's about 4." And they're like, nope, she's big. She's 6. So they were looking at the wrong age group for children. Now, what made this harder? Is this little girl didn't have her muster station bracelet on. If she still had that wristband on, it does tell you what their muster station is. So that would have cut down the amount of children that they had to look at going through all the photos in security. Now, she being autistic, I know firsthand what would have happened. She would have had a massive tantrum about having that wristband on. Alira did at first as well, and the parents would have just given up and taken it off. Try everything you can to get the children to wear that, because I watched them and I sat there for ages with them trying to go through and work out who this child was. And in fact, at first they thought it was another child, and the parents came down and they said, "No, that's not our daughter." So eventually, the mum called down and was freaking out because she had fallen asleep. She had a nap, and this little girl escaped outside the cabin. So I could see how it happened when we were sitting in the office. She was trying to go out every single door she could. So she was a little escape artist. It just reminds you, make sure you use the safety locks. Be very wary. I really felt for her because she did get a bit of a spray from the security guards, understandably, because it's safety and this little girl obviously needs 100% attention all the time. But on the other end of things, as a parent, how do you do that? So I really, really felt for the parents. They were extremely appreciative of what I had done. And I didn't expect anything out of it. For me, this was just me being a mum, and just helping out a little lost girl and helping out the parents too, making sure their little girl was safe. So guest services did send me a bottle of champagne and a plate of cookies to say thank you, which I very much appreciated. I did not want or expect anything to me. The reward was watching this little girl get reunited with her mum. But the way it was handled was pretty good. I think it's just a reminder. So if you do have children with additional needs, make sure you do alert the cruise line so that they are aware of that and that they can help assist you with that, because they do have sensory packs for ASD children, or anyone with any sort of sensory needs, and they've got some sensory little toys in there. They've got your earmuffs. It's hard, but someone like her, I feel like she would need some sort of identification on her. Even just trying to convince her to wear that muster band would have made a big difference in them trying to identify who the child was. But anyway, so that's just a bit of a story of something that happened on this cruise, and a bit of a cautionary tale, I guess, for anyone with children with additional requirements, not even additional needs. Another video went viral probably about 2 years ago. There was a little toddler or something running around in a nappy through the corridors on a ship. And this lady, see, my first reaction was to take the child down to guest services and try to find who the parents were. Her reaction, however, was to film this child and say, "Who let their child out? Who's letting their child run through these hallways in their diaper?" So there's a very different approach to that, that I am not okay with, just pulling your phone out and filming someone's child and plastering it all over the internet, especially while they're running around in nothing but a nappy. So, just try to be more aware of where your children are. There is some safety locks, like some up high locks on the doors that you can use. So, and the doors are very heavy as well. So they're not easy for children to open, but just try to put all the safety measures in to make sure you know where your children are at all times and that they're not escaping. I mean, even some bells on the door. I don't know. I don't know what this woman could have done, but I feel like a child like that with such special needs and clearly an escape artist, you need to put everything in place that you can to try to prevent such an incident, because you don't want them climbing up the rails and, God forbid, they climb up on some furniture out on the balcony, they lean over the rails, you know the end. So we don't want that. Anyway, I am rambling. I'm rambling. So I'm going to get back to it. And back to the vlog now. So this was 80s night. You'll see the kids in their little outfits. You might notice some little stickers on Alira's ears. She really wanted earrings like mummy. So we just took these little, they were frozen stickers that we had in with us, and we just put those on her ears, and she felt absolutely fabulous with her lipstick and her earrings and all her jewelry. Are you pretty? Show me your earrings, baby.
No, baby.
Where's your necklace? Where's your earrings? Where's your bow? Are you pretty? Where's your lipstick? Watched the rock show, so we had a real treat on this one. This is Stephen Williams. He did an incredible job. He was just in filling in for Deshaun, giving him a bit of a break, but he was incredible. It was a real treat for us.
Thank you.
we watched the sunset that night, it was time to say farewell to some of our favourite crew members, and also it was time for the 80s rock and glow. And now it was finally disembarkation day. So that is Benji there. That was Ty's favourite waiter. He really insisted for breakfast that morning that we go and see Benji, and he had a cry when we left. So we made sure we add him on Facebook. So we've still got that connection there with Benji, which is lovely. So thank you for watching this vlog. I hope you did get something out of it. I know it's a bit patchy and a bit all over the place, but like I said, this whole channel was started for me to vlog our family memories. So whether you've got something out of it or not, I don't know. But for us, these are cherished family memories, and that's why I wanted to put this video together, so that we still got those family memories together from that cruise all in one nice long video. So thank you for watching. I do have better vlogs coming up. I can't wait to bring another Splendor vlog, another back-to-back Splendor vlog to you very shortly. So do make sure you subscribe. I promise there will be more entertaining videos, but please like this video, subscribe to see more, and I'll see you in the next one.